Welcome back. The Atlanta International Auto Show returns tomorrow, bringing together the latest model cars, trucks, and SUVs inside the Georgia World Congress Center.
But this year, a vehicle built more than 60 years ago will be stealing away much of the attention. Good day, Atlanta's Paul Milliken. He likes to get a little attention himself from time to time. He's live at the Georgia World Congress Center, going back to the future this morning. First of all, about that McLaren, it looks very nice. It it's going to get hard to get used to seeing you in something besides that Pinto that you drive, though. It's going to be tough.
I know. It's a little bit of an upgrade. You know, it's a little known fact that, the name McLaren is derived from Milliken.
That
we're all
in
the same family.
Yeah.
So I kind of already do own it. They just, the McLaren people don't know that yet, but I'm going to try to figure out how that works. Yeah, so we're talking about the Atlanta Auto Show. It is back again. And it's really amazing the variety of vehicles that you'll see when you're here at the Georgia World Congress Center. You'll see stuff like this, flashy, new, amazing vehicles, but you'll also see some stunning pieces of history. And we're going to show you that in just a minute. First, though, our good friend J.W. Southwick hanging out this morning. Good to see you. How
good
are you?
Good to see you. How are you?
I'm doing well. It's a little bit chilly, but it's going to be a great weekend. Perfect for the auto show. And this really is such a great time for the family to come down and just hang out for the day, right?
Absolutely. It's a fantastic show we've got in store. We've got some fans, some great exhibits like the McLaren that you'll see here. Caffeine and Octane is with us.
Yeah.
And it is a family event. We've got great attractions like Black Panther, Scooby-Doo, SpongeBob SquarePants. We have a BMX show that'll be going on during the event. So there's lots to see and do. We also have a career fair that'll be running Wednesday through Thursday. So if you're in the market for a job, come check it out.
That's great. Also, great deal to get into. Admission is not expensive at all.
That's correct. It's adult admission is $12. Yep. Kids 6 through 12 are $6, and kids under 6 are free.
Now, you mentioned the superheroes and the great cars, but you forgot the number one attraction. The Fox 5 team is going to be here.
Well, of course. That goes without saying, so I didn't have to say that.
We've got the Fox 5 Storm Chaser. We're going to be here. Thank you very much. Let's talk about one of the biggest attractions, though. Tim, spin around and show it. Ladies and gentlemen, one of the rarest vehicles on the planet. There it is. And it's beautiful. This is the Futureliner number 10. And this is Don, who is from the National Auto and Truck Museum, where this vehicle permanently lives. Now, this is a fascinating vehicle. It was built in 1939. Why was this built?
General Motors wanted to put technology on parade for the whole nation. And so they took 12 of these on the road every year through the summer and would demonstrate things like television, microwave, stereophonic sound when people had never heard of such a thing.
So the way it would work is that the sides would open up and there would be big displays in there, right?
That is correct. And there would be one individual up there would conduct like a lecture demonstrating how a jet engine operated or whatever they wanted to feature.
Very cool. So what happened? Why did they go away?
Well, they toured until the war. Yep. They were mothballed. They started again in 1953, and then they went to 1957. And by that time, one of the things that they had introduced, television, had gotten so popular in the American home, people no longer wanted to go out and see things. They could see it in their living room.
Yeah, so ironically, they were talking about television on the road, and then television kind of killed them. But here's the good news. TV is back, and now we're showing it off this morning. It's so rare because, again, only 12 were made. How many are left out there today?
There are 9 left. 3 are in Europe. There are 6 in the U.S. There have only been a couple that have been restored. One's been made into a motorhome. One's been made into a car hauler, of all things.
Well, where did you guys get this one? And when you got it, what did it look like?
When we got it, it was just a rusted hulk, and no one really thought it could be restored.
Yeah.
A gentleman named Joe Bortz in Chicago had 6 of them, and he donated one of them to us.
That's fantastic. How many years did it take to make it look like this? Because it looks brand new.
It took 7 years. There was a dedicated group of retired GM employees that restored it for us.
Wow, amazing. And Tim, if you would, just poke inside. How many people could ride in this thing?
Just 3. Okay. The driver and 2 backup drivers. The whole rear area is just for display purposes.
Yep. And again, this weekend when folks come out, they actually will get to step inside the cab, which is a very rare opportunity for folks.
Absolutely. They'll be able to get up and sit in the driver's seat and just see the view from up there.
Nice. Life in 1939. I love it. Again, back in 1939, they thought this was the future of automobiles, right?
Absolutely. Absolutely it was.
And what turned out was that was the future of automobiles. Coming up in the next hour, we're talking more about the McLaren and Caffeine and Octane, but I have some good news. So here's the thing. I've made some deals because, you know, I'm always wheeling and dealing. So what we're going to do is we're going to trade the Fox 5 Storm Chaser, and we're going to get both of these vehicles. So I'm going to just hang out in this because I love the Futureliner. I think it's very Paul Milliken. It's classic. It's stylish, just like me. Sharon is going to get the McLaren because the names rhyme, so I think that's
Sharon
perfect.
McLaren.
Sharon and her McLaren.
Yeah,
and then Buck
it.
Lanford
like
is
that.
Just going to get that beautiful Fox 5 live truck back there.
That's what I drive to work every day.
I think it's
anyway.
Got about, what, maybe 300,000, 400,000 miles on it.
That is
so,
funny.
Buck, congratulations. There's yours, and Sharon,
in her
we'll
McLaren.
See you in her McLaren. How about that?
And I'm going to give you the old chrome horn in that big van, too. Don't you worry about that, Paul. Thanks a lot. This year's auto show opens at noon tomorrow, runs through Sunday at the Georgia World Congress Center. Admission is only $12 for adults, only $6 for children.